No, you can. It's a, this is rubber.
Alright. So what are we going to do?
Either way, it's going uphill.
Yeah, that is. Not much
of a move. Okay, so your start point is touch the box.
Yep.
That's your start point. You can't, you have to stay within hand reach of these.
Yep.
Okay? So it's basically representing that this is quite close confined. Effectively imagine another wall or an edge there.
Cool.
Alright, so Dave, we're going to start. So that box there is one start point. Okay? And there's a little rock thing here. That's basically another start point. Okay? You can't go out wider than an arm's reach. Okay? So we're basically, and watch out for this bit. Don't trip on that. Okay? So when we're coming down into here, you actually need to sort of come in a bit.
I'm just trying to line it up for him. Because like, where that guy is a start point, so I just want all of it to be there.
Or you hold it.
Actually,
basically, that bit will
work.
Okay? And we're staying close to these, and it's just exploring what's there, and
Seeing
what we can, and then trying to work out a solution to deal with it. Go back to your box.
I need to. Oh, sorry. Back.
Back to your box.
Oh, my butt's wet.
Back in the box, Magnus.
Lay on. So when you guys are doing stuff, take it in turns to lead.
Yep.
Okay? Back to your box.
Oh, that would have been even funny.
And now you go back to the monster.
That was a moment in the labyrinth when they're all running
around. Lion!
This explains a lot of D&D
stuff. Yeah.
Yeah. Play on!
Oh, Jesus. It was beautiful. Handling a cheeky bastard.
Come on, this is the guy who takes weapons from other fighters and he's fighting.
Yeah, well, sure.
Yeah, like, yeah. I mean, they sure must have just offered himself up.
Everything kind of funnels just around the edges, doesn't it? Yeah, yeah.
two. Now go to that side and play defensive on that side.
Okay.
Changes completely which way we're attacking. Right. You ready? Okay. Play on. There's my neck. I swear he dodged.
It bounced off him.
It's just like he's sitting to the side and neck.
Oh no.
So you got me one nicely in the lower target zone.
You didn't look up, Amy. She's taking pictures of us too. She's taking pictures of everyone.
Well, I would have picked up if I knew.
Nice, I actually didn't think you were going to do that, and I was like, oh, that play is on his own.
I was going, why is he on his own? Oh!
The trick is,
why is he on his own? It's like, if he's on his own, that means the other one's around here somewhere.
Right behind me!
I was like, shit!
Also good D&D rules.
Yeah.
Oh, no, rule rules. That's not D&D, kangaroos. There's always another.
Yeah.
They always travel in a mob.
It's like, if you see one on your own, run. One on its own, run.
If Elena tries to see you,
It's only human tend to attack it.
True.
Because of all kind of things. Otherwise, kangaroos generally don't attack for no reason.
Yeah. They're just like, yeah, whatever. Oh, human, okay.
Unless they've, like, been attacked recently. Then it's like, huh, you're probably one of those motherfuckers.
Yeah.
Yeah, they're probably getting that one off.
The kangaroos down in Hulk's aren't that bad.
Yeah,